Janina here. So today I'm going to do a very requested video, how I edit my Instagram photos. So I'm finally going to reveal all of my secrets to you guys. Joke lang, I don't have any secrets. It's actually super simple, and when you find out how I do it, you'll be like, what? I could have done that without this video. Yes, I know that my feed is not the best out there. I'm still working on it until now. Like, I'm constantly trying to make it better. Like, I go through short bursts of a really nice feed and then really ugly ones. So I think right now I'm on the uglier side, to be honest, but I'm still gonna do this video for you guys. But before I get into my tips and tricks and the plain how I edit my photos on Instagram, oh my gosh, sorry, I had to turn off all the electric fans and the air cons and stuff like that. It's like, you know, for audio. That's good, I love Misty. I just want to quickly talk to you guys about your responsibility on social media. Social media is a wonderful thing. I love social media. You guys know that I love social media. I'm on Instagram, on Twitter, on Snapchat, on Facebook, on Friendster, on Multiply, on whatever else there is there. I'm on it. I think it's so cool that I get to talk to like thousands of people at a time about what I'm doing, and I get to talk to strangers from around the world, and I get to talk to you guys. I get to keep my friends updated. Honestly, my mind still can't comprehend how that works, but with great power, you guys know this, comes great responsibility. And not just because you can means you should. I mean, I'm not saying that you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that, you shouldn't post this, you should post that, but like, you can post whatever you want, you can tweet whatever you want, but I hope that when we post something, even me, I hope that when I post something, I'll think first, why am I posting this? Is there a good purpose behind posting this? Am I actually giving value to people when I post this? Is it encouraging or is it discouraging? Will I hurt someone's feelings or will I actually make them feel better? So I hope with our social media, with my social media, I will be kind, I will be truthful, and I will be encouraging with whatever I post. TBH, I haven't really thought this through, so I'm just going to try and ramble to you guys my tips on how to have a better feed. So my first tip actually goes for photos and videos as well, and it's to find good lighting. I personally love daylight. It makes the quality of the photos so good, and also TBH, wala akong budget pang professional lighting. Another thing that makes your feed look really good is the quality of your photos. I use a DSLR or my point and shoot. I never use my iPhone to take photos, and I know that's kind of stressful for some people because they don't want to lug around a camera, but it really makes a difference, eh? I swear, it does make a difference. Like, it's not grainy, and the colors really pop out more when you use a quality camera. Good quality cameras take good quality photos, and that will give you a good quality feed. My next tip is to stick to a theme. You guys probably already know this. A lot of people go for the monochromatic side, like the black and white. Some people go for maroons and grays. But me personally, I go for pastels and bright pinks and bright blues. Well, you guys know how my room looks like. You guys know what my personality is like. And I really like it that when people go through my Instagram, they kind of get a taste of who I am already. And I think that's what gives people kind of a first impression of me. That's why I go for bright colors. I personally just think it looks so much better that way. It's so fun and colorful. It's super like maaliwalas. This is kind of my secret. It's not really a secret, but then this is like my secret weapon. Yeah. Nature looks so good on your feed. It just makes everything look so nice. And I am a city girl. I live in the city. I'm in the city most of my life. And I rarely ever go to the beach or like the tree area. So when you guys go out to nature, I would really suggest taking as many photos as you can. And I'm not saying take 100 photos and then post 100 photos that same week. Iniipon ko siya. Tapos when my feed is feeling a little bit dead, or it's like it's dying, or it's not that nice anymore, what I do is I post a feed fixer. I call them feed fixers because when my feed looks ugly and I post a beach photo, my feed automatically gets refreshed. If you guys remember, I was actually in Casa Corazon a few weeks ago, and you guys also probably noticed that I'm still posting photos from then because I did take a lot of photos and they really fixed my feed. That's why I call them feed fixers. Oh, another tip, I forgot. Another thing that makes your feed look so nice is not posting so much of yourself. are not posting so much of people. I think flat lays and nature shots and walls and floors and things, they make your feed look so good. I still post people, don't worry. I love keeping the memories. Flat lays are the bomb. Flat lays just automatically make you look so professional, to be honest. Speaking of flat lays, I'm going to show you guys how I edit mine. I typically use 3 apps for this per photo. I know, it's like, it's work. My first app is Snapseed. Whoa, shocker, Janina uses Snapseed. I know, okay, everybody uses Snapseed. I know that's what you're thinking, but it's the bomb. I think you do have to pay a few dollars for it, but for me, it's worth it, especially because Instagram's kind of part of my work, my job, so yeah. Nobody actually taught me, I just experimented and found what worked for me, and this is what works for me. Okay, so when I'm in Snapseed, I just press the pencil, press tune image, and I use like the 4 fixer-upper effects. Number 1 is brightness. I turn up brightness so much. I know it looks washed out, but don't worry, the next effect will fix that. I love ambiance. Like, that is, I think, my secret weapon. All the time, it's ambiance. It just makes everything look so colorful, and it gives the photo a lot of depth. It gives a photo a lot of depth. So, ambiance is the bomb. And if my photo is still a bit washed out from the brightness, I will bring up contrast. And since my feed is on the more colorful side, saturation is a must. Also, what I love about Snapseed is if you click the photo, you can see the before and after. Before, after. Do you see it?
Did you see it? Did you see it? I'm so proud.
Before, after. I just think it's so satisfying to see your work. It's just like, yes, I did it. Then after that, you can of course save your photo. You can save the photo to replace the old one, or you can save it as a new one. Let's just save it as a new one right now. Okay, my next app is VSCO. VSCO. VSCO, whichever, VSCO. I think it's VSCO. Okay, whatever. This app is the bomb.com. This one makes everything look so coherent. And if you notice, there are photos here that I haven't posted because this is kind of like my trial area where I see if it will work with my feed, and if it won't, that's why there are photos that got stuck here and just never were able to see the light of day because they just didn't match my feed. There are 2 ways I edit my photos. One is the easier one, which is just to use a filter. I use the filter K3, which honestly you do have to buy. You have to buy it, but I love it so much because it just brings out the pink in every photo. Sometimes if I feel it, I bring it up to +9 and maybe even +12 sometimes, but today I'm feeling +6. But I'm also going to show you guys the other way that I edit my photos on VSCO, which is using the tint. So what I do is I scroll through the different effects and I press this, I think it's a dropper looking thing, and I bring the tint up to maybe +4 or +6, and that will just instantly give my photos that pink tint that make everything again look cohesive and coherent. There, see? There's not much difference, but it makes a difference to me. Okay, so we can go to Instagram now, and you know, if you're not following me on Instagram yet, you can totally follow me. It's Janina.Bella. Of course, you know I had to do a shameless plug.
We're already here, right?
Okay, sorry, I forgot to save my photo from VSCO. And then I can import it to Instagram. My last step is to bring up the brightness just a little bit more. Because again, I want everything to look super bright and fun and just like, oh, not too much. I really don't want my photo to be washed out, but I just want it to be bright. And that's it. I'll put a caption. And that's it. That's how I edit my flat lays. And now for my next picture, aka my last picture, I'm going to teach you guys how I edit my feed fixers. Okay, I'm going to edit again one of my favorite ones, and we're going to do it again on Snapseed. Tune image, turn up the brightness, yo. Turn up the ambiance, contrast, and saturation. But I don't want to saturate it too much because since I am in the photo, my skin might look too orange. That's why I don't use saturation too much when there are humans in my photos. What I do to make the colors pop more is I go to tools and I go to selective, and then I kind of change the radius so that it's all around the sky, and Turn up saturation a lot. So you see how that makes such a big difference? I'm going to do the same thing to the other side, just so it's pantay. Because you know. And now the sky looks so much bluer and just more vibrant, and love it. Now again, the satisfying feeling of seeing the difference before, after. Before and after. Yay, I love it. Okay, save as a copy as usual and go to Visio. Visco. I think it's Visco. I'm not sure. Okay, to be honest, I use the filter a lot. It's just that one stubborn photo sometimes, and it just the filter and the photo, they just don't match. And you know, wag mo na i-post kung hindi talaga match, diba? Yes. Okay. And that is it, pansit. I always save it as actual size because again, quality makes a big difference in my photos. Go to Instagram. And for this photo, I don't feel like editing it again, so I'm just gonna post it just like that. Okay. So that's it. Now your feet can look as nice as mine and we can be feed twinning. Let me know what was the most helpful tip for you guys, and if you have other tips that you want to share to me, maybe something that I did wrong or something that you think will make my feed look better, I'd really like to know. Also, maybe we can like get a conversation going down there and help each other out, help a sister out, help our feeds out. Let's make all of our feeds be on fleek together, because that is how you make the world a better place. If you have better feeds, don't quote me on that. Just kidding, but if you have a good feed, hopefully your heart is just as good. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a, you know what it is, thumbs up. And let's try to get this video to, what is our magic number for today? 3,261 likes. I don't know why I chose that number. Maybe it's a magic number. I don't know. But let's try to reach it. As always, I know that we can reach it because we, Bella Fam Squad, we the bomb. We can do it. Let's achieve it together. Let's go, people. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a wonderful summer, and may the feed of your Instagram always be on fleek. Bye!